Karen Lumley is the Conservative MP for Redditch. Karen, you're hearing what Neil was saying there. It's insane. I know you're going to vote yes for this. It's an insane decision, he says.
Well, I think, you know, good morning, first of all, Howard. I think, yeah, these people are vile, disgusting people, and, you know, we can't allow this to continue. You know, in your report, you quite rightly mentioned that the EU is saying that 3,000, you know, Europeans are going out there. You know, what happens if they come back to our country and try to do similar things in our country? You know, do we put our own security at risk because of that? My answer to that is no.
But is the answer to this for airstrikes to do as we did before, and as Neil Lawrenson was saying, it made Al-Qaeda stronger?
Well, I don't necessarily agree with that, but I actually think that, you know, these people have got to be stopped. We're at the beginning of what could be incredibly dangerous for the whole of the world. You know, the Americans already in there, it's already been 200 airstrikes, which apparently, according to John Kerry, have been extremely accurate, and that's got to be right. We've got to send a message out that this is not right, this has got to stop, and we've got to stop it now. Some of you people in your Vox Pop earlier said, you know, it's got to be stopped at the beginning, and it has. We can't allow this to carry on. We can't allow these people to, you know, torture people, which is what they're doing. Let's be clear, they're torturing Iraqi people. You know, this country went through, whether you agreed with the war or not, and to be fair, I didn't, we agreed that troops, our troops should have gone in, but
Karen, let's accept that the vote, it's looking likely, because all three main parties are looking like they're behind, it's going to be a yes. What's the timescale then? Because we have to learn from history here, and having an end game in Iraq and Afghanistan were the mistakes that were made, which have been acknowledged. What's the timescale you're working on for these airstrikes?
Well, I'm not privy to that information, Howard, but I shall listen very carefully to the Prime Minister when he speaks at 10 this morning.
But you're still happy to vote, not knowing the full picture?
No, I'm happy to give the Prime Minister, that he has asked for our vote. I will be giving him that vote today, because I know that we cannot allow those people to carry on suffering in Iraq. That's not fair, it's not right, and it's got to stop. And that's why I'll be giving him my vote. I will listen very carefully to what he has to say today, and it's been very, very clear in the motion. This is only about Iraq, this is only about airstrikes, this is not about troops on the ground, and this does not involve Syria.
Why not Syria? Why, it's like plugging half a hole. It's still going to leak.
This is Syria is a different issue, and I remember coming back last year on a call back to Parliament to recall about Syria last year, and as you all your viewers and you will remember, we lost the vote on that, because I was one of the people that said I could not ever vote to put ground troops into these countries again unless there was a very, very specific reason why we should. That's why it's been made very clear today in the motion there are no ground troops and there's nothing on Syria. This is about making sure that we stop ISIL in Iraq, we make sure that we protect innocent people, and we give the Iraqi government that's asked for our help, specifically an elected, democratically elected government has asked for our help, and we would be very wrong to turn our back on them.
Karen Lumley, thank you. Conservative MP for Redditch.